I've studied chemical and thermal process technology and thermal energy technology in the 90s of the last century. Learning about the second law of thermodynamics, I've understood that burning gas at temperatures of more than 1200 degrees C is not the smartest way of heating rooms at a room temperature of 21 degrees C. Heat pumps can take more than 75% of the required energy for heating a room from the cold outside air or from the ground, and thus save primary energy and CO2 emissions. This is why I wanted to work with heat pumps, and that is what I'm doing to this day. People are at the center of everything I do. Being responsible for a company with more than 4,000 employees, most of the work I want to have done has to be done by others. In short words, I need my coworkers and my staff more than they need me. Having good ideas is certainly not a problem I'm facing. Talking with installers, seeing how people are living, how they are using their computers, their smartphones, or their cars, and seeing the problems that residential buildings are facing, I'm good and fast at developing ideas for products that can improve the life of people or the quality of buildings. The difficult and important thing is to get people involved and make them love what they are doing. Thus, it is often better to work on their ideas than to work on my own ideas. Everyone loves his own baby most. Appreciate the contribution of others. Give them the freedom to follow their ideas, enrich their work, and celebrate success. That is how I try to make a difference. And work closely together. Being used to working with computers, video conferences, emails, and messengers, I'm the most analog person when it comes to collaboration. Put everyone together in a narrow space. Use brown paper or a flip chart to collect ideas and proposals, and discuss topics directly in the production line or the lab. That is how I love to work and how I believe creativity is unleashed. People with ideas, people who are solution-oriented, and people who accept, promote, and motivate others. Professor Fritz Steimle, my PhD supervisor, came from a rich family. He and I had nothing in common, apart from our interest in thermodynamics. He never cared. At his institute, you had to follow certain rules. One was that the lab had to be clean before you went home. The next day, a customer might visit. Apart from the rules, you were free to do what you wanted, as long as you could explain to him why it made sense. It was a perfect working environment. Frank Rogge, who was CEO of Stibel-Eltron when I entered the company, put me into a working group that was to work out if we should discontinue to work with heat pumps or if we could make the heat pump business a success for the company. After 2 weeks, I went to him and told him that I did not want to create more PowerPoint presentations, but wanted to get started on making the heat pump business a success. He asked me whom I needed on the team and how long it would take me. I told him the people I needed and promised to get the turnaround done in 2 years. It took us 4 years. Frank Rogge never complained, and we would never have succeeded without his help and support. And of course, he teases me until today about my wrong judgment. And of course, I must not forget Karl Ochsner, an Austrian heat pump pioneer, who made the European Heat Pump Association what it is today, and who founded a new company developing, producing, and selling industrial heat pumps sometime around his 70th birthday. He is more alive than a lot of 30-year-old people I know. Motivate people, of course. It doesn't become easier with being responsible for more people. Closeness helps. But how to be close to 4,000 people often enough? So I try. Try to say what I do and do what I say. Explain and work hard and never forget that no one is stupid and that she or he has reasons for thinking differently than I do. Apart from people, digitalization. Of course, this is not our core business, but it is the most important enabler for everything we do. I have to understand enough of Industry 4.0, internet connectivity, data analytics and other things to talk with people who know more about it than I do. And together, we must find out where digitalization helps us to improve our business. And at Stiebel-Eltron, we need to find the right people with the right competence. It is challenging and fun. Forget it. There are too many strong companies around in this market today. You should have asked me the same question 10 years ago. Alternatively, you have a disruptive idea and know how to build a heat pump that is much more efficient or quiet or loads cheaper than what the whole industry is doing today. Or you know about a completely different business model, doing something different than selling your heat pumps to installers or house builders or wholesalers. Yes, I'm sure that the conditions have never been better. Of course, there is a lot of political work in detail that still must be done by the different member states of the European community. But in general, the European Green Deal is outlining the way for the industry and allows the industry to adapt to the future markets. We really must thank the Fridays for Future movement for their impact. They have created a political awareness for climate protection that science and the European Green Parties and all the NGOs have failed to create for years. If I knew it, do you really think I would tell you? So, I can just tell you what everyone in the industry knows. The installation of heat pumps must become easier. The planning of heat pumps and installations of heat pumps must be simplified. The efficiency of heat pumps should be increased, while the GWP value of the refrigerants, the amount of refrigerant in the heat pumps, and the sound emission of the heat pumps must be reduced. All heat pumps must be connected to the cloud. Energy management systems must be implemented and new business models for services must be developed and implemented. Maybe heating residential buildings via the air volume flow of the ventilation system can be a smart alternative to hydraulic flow heating systems and radiators. Of course it has. Heat pumps are probably one of the products having the greatest benefit from the digitalization. It is needed for energy management and it allows more efficient service models. And if we want to make the planning of heat pump systems and the order process easier for our customers, then digital platforms and tools are the way to improve our business model. Heat pumps will quickly substitute gas boilers as the most important heating system in the market. There are alternatives, like pellet boilers or district heating, but the mass market will be heat pumps. They allow an efficient and affordable heating of every building with renewable energy. And they have the additional advantage that they can not only heat, but also cool the buildings, and thus provide additional comfort. As an industry, we must make heat pumps easier to install, easier to service, cheaper and even more reliable than they are today. Politics should make sure that the efficiency of heat pumps pays off for the end customer by saving money. Therefore, electricity must not be too expensive compared to gas or oil. To reach the number of installed heat pumps we need to fulfill the climate protection targets of the Paris Climate Agreement, we need a high exchange rate of the boilers in the field and thus more heating installers than we have today. The profession of the heating installer must become more attractive to encourage young people to choose it. Talking about political measures on a detail level, subsidies for young installers starting their own business will help. And providing securities that ensure the payment of salaries for installers willing to expand their business will help them to take the decision to grow.